Hi friends, in this video we are going to talk about 7th house, 7th house in astrology. I am trying to do these videos in English so that you can, so people from non-Tamil background can understand it, since I got so many requests to do it in English. So my grammar will be okay-ish, so please adjust with that. Hope you can understand beyond my grammar mistakes. Okay, so 7th house in astrology. 7th house is the most sensitive house in astrology, because nowadays astrology is predominantly used in marriage and the marriage is related to 7th house. So obviously 7th house is something which people are always looking at. Okay, and there are many myths surrounding the 7th house. Okay, for example, in 7th house, if there is Saturn, then there is a delay in marriage. If 7th house, there is something Raghu or Ketu, then it is a Rahu Ketu dosham comes into place, and so many things are there. Okay, so we'll try to see one by one. Okay, first, the 7th house is all about marriage partners or any other partner, and also client. Okay, these are all the major portion of the 7th house. In depth, 7th house represent meeting somebody, that's it. Okay, when it comes to marriage, we meet somebody daily. That is the only difference. So that is how 7th house is allotted for marriage. Okay, so in 7th house, what will happen if any of the planets placed? Okay, so it is not only placement of the planet, since we are using Kepi chart, we are based on Kepi methodology, we will be dealing with the interconnections, Bhava interconnection. Okay, that means even though there is no planet in our 7th house, there is an interconnection between the placement of the Bhava, 7th Bhava. Okay, every Bhava point, okay, that represent a planet, that represent a nakshatra lord, sub lord, sub sub lord. All these things are interconnected to the 7th Bhava. Okay, so 7th Bhava placement, 7th Bhava represent planets which are in 7th Bhava, and planet that represent the nakshatra lord of the 7th Bhava, planet that represent sub lord of the 7th Bhava, planet that represent sub sub lord of the 7th Bhava. In all these things, 7th Bhava sublord is the most powerful thing. Okay, not the placement, not the planet placed. Okay, old traditional astrology, they mainly see the placement of the planet in the 7th Bhava, but for us it is not that much important. That is a secondary thing only. And there is a very big assumption, like if 7th Bhava have malefic planets, then definitely it will lead to delay in marriage. So I totally disagree with this point. Why? First of all, I don't agree with many benefic and malefic kind of division in planets. Planet is an energy form. Every energy form has its own purpose. It is not a right way to look at it as in a judgmental way, saying this is right planet, this is wrong planet kind of things, which is irrational and have nothing to add to science of astrology. Okay, so then you may ask, if 7th Bhava Saturn is there, why my marriage is delaying? Okay, like that. See, it is not about 7th Bhava, whether it's a Saturn or whatever planet it is. Okay, there is a high chance of delay in marriage because of some other reason. First of all, you understand, each Bhava represents some purpose. And if a planet placed in that Bhava or interconnected in that Bhava, then definitely the planet's job is to get things done. For example, if 7th Bhava, let us assume Venus in the 7th Bhava. That means Venus planet is responsible for your marriage. What does that mean? Venus represents beauty. So a girl who is beautiful, or a spouse, or a guy who is beautiful will be your partner, or maybe your partner. Okay. And you like them as a partner. Okay, so that is the 7th Bhava representation. So you have any planet, okay, so we can start from, I will explain you from Saturn to Shukra, like Venus. Okay, from Sun to Venus. First, the sun represent, you will have a partner who is dominant, who is bossy, who can have leadership qualities. If 7th Bhava, Moon is present in 7th Bhava, or Moon is interconnected in 7th Bhava, then it represents emotional, mood-oriented, creative person, maybe your partner. If seventh bhava or seventh house connected to Mars, then you will get an you are okay with, you are comfortable with a person who is angry, short-tempered, but at the same time very ferocious and have a quality of protecting others. That kind of person will be your partner. And if seventh bhava is connected to Rahu, seventh bhava connected to Rahu, it represent you will get a person who is more concerned about their health, who may be foodie, who want to break the rules kind of person. Okay. If seventh bhava is connected to Saturn, then you will get a partner who is a hard worker. Okay. If seventh bhava is connected to Mercury, or seventh house has a Mercury planet, then Mercury represent knowledgeable person, a person who is extrovert, who can communicate with anyone. Okay, that kind of person will be your spouse or partner. Next one, seventh bhava, which is connected to Ketu, that represent people who think deeply. Okay, are your partner. Okay, who has wisdom, who try to solve problems, that kind of person. And if seventh bhava connected to Venus, that represent, I already told you, beauty kind of person who is more concerned about beauty. That kind of person will be your partner. Okay, so this is how from Sun to Venus. Then you may ask, I have seventh bhava, okay, why the marriage is not happening? I have seventh bhava, let us assume you have seventh bhava with Mercury, but the marriage is not happening in Mercury Buddhi. So in general, the assumption or in general theory is, any particular planet which is placed in that bhava or connected to that bhava, okay, in its buddhi, it will help you to solve that problem first. Or if that planet is in some other nakshatra interconnected, then that planet will solve that problem. Okay. For example, if you have seventh bhava connected to Mercury, then if Mercury buddhi comes, you will get married. But let us assume you are at the age of 25, but Mercury Buddhi for you is coming at 35. So that doesn't mean you have to wait for 10 years. Okay. This Mercury may have connected, any planet that is placed on the Mercury Nakshatra will also do the marriage for you. Let us assume Venus is connected to Mercury in your chart. Then what will happen was, during Venus Buddhi, you will get a partner who is beautiful. In general, you might have get a partner who is knowledgeable, but since the marriage is happening through Venus, then Venus will give its property and try to find a partner in its property. It will help you. So Venus is connected to Mercury, means Venus will do the marriage for you. Okay. So hope you now understand the theory clearly. So now you can ask, like, if seventh bhava Mercury is there, Mercury Buddhi is also coming to me. Mercury Buddhi was there last year, but still I could not get married. What might be the reason? The reason is, it is not about what is placed there. It is about the interconnection. If this planet Mercury is connected to sixth bhava as well, that is 12th house of the seventh house, any house or any bhava, the 12th bhava represents its opposite house. It will stop that. If 4 represent building a house, 3 represent stopping the building the house. If 3 represent travel, 2 represent stopping the travel. So like that, everything with its 12th bhava, it reacts opposite. It will stop that. Okay. So in this scenario, here, 7th bhava, if it is connected to your 6th bhava, let us assume what we have assumed is Mercury. If 7th bhava Mercury is connected to 6th bhava, definitely Mercury cannot do marriage for you. You cannot find a right partner in that time. Okay, then how marriage will happen? As I already told, if the Mercury is connected, if any planet connected to Mercury, like as I already told, if the Venus is there, then Venus may help you to get married. Okay, So here, there is another thing you need to be very clear. So this seventh bhava, you may, so what is the conclusion of these things? First thing is, seventh bhava, either it is a Saturn, Rahu or Kedu, any malefic in that way. I don't believe in malefics. I'm telling you in the traditional perspective. Okay. If there is a malefic, it doesn't mean delay in marriage. Marriage delay is due to the seventh bhava interconnected to the sixth bhava. Okay, that is the main reason. And the second thing is, there is no Rahu, Kedu, Dosha Mandala. I have clearly explained in many posts and also in another video. Even myself and my sister both have Rahu Kedu Dosham. Her marriage delayed for 10 years, but my marriage happened just like that. I just loved a girl and I married her. So what is the difference? The real difference is not about Rahu Kedu in the 7th house. The difference is, for her the 7th house interconnected to 6th house, so her marriage delayed. While my 7th house interconnected to 5th house, which represents love marriage. So I got love marriage. So it is all about interconnection, bhava connection. There is nothing about malefic or benefic. So don't believe in that. It has any logic. It has no logic attached to it. Okay. There is no judgmental thing in astrology. Every planet, whomsoever it may concern, like it can be Jupiter or whatever it is. Jupiter you may call it as most benefic. There is nothing most benefic and all. It is not judged. You see, Jupiter, if it is good, it will guide people. At the same time, it will criticize others. Okay. It will bring you trouble through criticism. And you can easily judge people. Which create more problems in your marriage life. Okay. So there is no benefic or malefic. Every planet has positive side. Every planet has negative side. A hardworking Saturn is also a lazy person. There is no person who is hard worker and active. It's about lazy and hard worker is the two sides of the Saturn planet. Like that. So there is no benefic or malefic. Don't confuse with that. And if your 7th house is good, if 7th house is not connected to 6th bhava, you will get married easily. If 7th house is a minimal planet connections and they are also interconnected to 6th bhava, then your marriage will be delayed indefinitely. It is very tough. And the last important point is, if all your 7th bhava is connected to 6th bhava, you may ask whether I will not at all get married. Okay, there is a high chance to it. But the reality is, you yourself will not be comfortable in having a married life. That is important. Because astrology is a human psychology. If you don't like something, it is already represented in your astrology chart. So chart is not something away from you. Chart is your psychology. So what you can do if all the 7th bhava is led to 6th bhava? In that time, we have to check about 3-9 bhavas through which you can try to match you with a relationship which is online or a distant relationship. Marrying a girl and living in two different places, trying to live in two different places. That is out of scope to this video. We will discuss about it in future. Let me know, do you like this video, the video in English? If you want to continue myself in English, just let me know in the comment section. So I will try to post more videos in English. Thank you.